So we're now at 0.81 Mach at 322 knots, just approaching 28,000 feet. And just to double check, it's 0.835 we want. And as always, we're making sure that the power is not too high, the power's not maxed out, to try and maintain 322 knots, otherwise we have to lower the nose. And 0.01 to go. Three, four, and I'll select it now, 3.5. Now, like I say, the simulator, the PMDG, is going to exceed that a little bit. It responds with the engines a little bit too late, so I'm just going to give it a boost to slow down the engines a bit more quickly. This is not real life procedure. Okay, there we are. So we're now climbing at a fixed Mach of 0.835, and if you watch the indicated airspeed, with constant climb, the speed will begin to reduce the indicated airspeed. But you can very clearly see the indicated airspeed is reducing. It was on 322, nearly lost 10 knots in just under 1500 feet. Two thousand feet. And we'll get the buzzer now for 900 feet to go. Should begin to lower the nose so we don't have any big power changes, and it helps the speed to be maintained as well. About to lose, probably about 30 knots we would have lost at the same Mach. Down to the last 300 feet per minute for a nice soft intercept of our cruise altitude. I'll bring up the cruise page now, which has just a second changed. and the computer's giving us an optimum flight level of 350, so just 1,000 feet short, but that's not a problem. We'll maintain 34,000 feet for the next short while, and at some point we'll climb up to about 36,000 feet. So as the VNAV page changed from climb, it's now inactive of course, to Econ Cruise, the climb restriction also increased up to cruise, so we now have cruise power, max cruise power available. And it recommends a cruise speed of 0.835, the same as the climb. That can be modified, and just to show you how that's done, I'll do that now. So we'll take a cruise of 0.845, no, let's be different, let's be random, 0.842. Just drop that in there, press execute. Now in real life you're normally flying on lateral navigation, which is following a magenta line, a path, and vertical navigation, which is adhering to the altitudes or speeds of those legs. So if I press VNAV, we won't get very far because I don't actually have any route or any paths to follow. So I'll have to make the change myself. But it's still nice to understand how it works. So we've just got to 0.842 again because of the looseness in holding airspeed during changes of PMDG. I'll set it just below, but it will break it. It will exceed 0.4. It responds too slowly with engine power changes to maintain an accurate speed. 0.841, 0.842. I'll just set it on there, that should be accurate. So 0.842. So a little bit further on in the flight now, we're just approaching the northern coast of Spain. Just gone past Bordeaux on the western coast of France. Cruising nicely at 34,000 feet, flight level 340. And an indicated airspeed of about 295, and our cruise Mach number of 0.842 as selected in the modified cruise page here. We are just going to make a left turn now, heading 180 degrees to take us to the north coast of Spain. So 180 degrees. And this will be taking us through the centre and a tiny bit to the east of Spain. And we'll just cut across in the last moment in towards Malaga a bit later on. Once we've leveled, I'd like to initiate a step climb up to 36,000 feet. The optimum cruise altitude doesn't need to be adhered to because it will change over time every 10 to 20 minutes because the plane is getting lighter. So to try and follow it every 10 minutes and climb 100 feet every so often is ridiculous. So you'll normally go 1 or 2,000 feet above it and be in the middle of the max altitude and the optimum altitude. So we're going to just go straight into the middle of those at 36,000 feet, and that should do us for the rest of the flight. So 36,000 in the altitude window, and we'll do an initial climb of 500 feet per minute just to see how the engines cope with that. This is called a cruise climb. Just about to start to see the north coast of Spain here, and the west of France is here. So the aircraft very capable of climbing at 1.55, maintaining a Mach 0.842 at 500 feet per minute. So I'm going to increase that rate of climb a little bit now to 800. as I always say, we're watching the power limits, make sure we're not overpowering the aircraft, we're not climbing too steeply. Thousand feet to go. And 900 to go. Our indicated airspeed, even though we did increase our Mach number a little bit, is still only at 283. If you remember, we were at 323, so that's 30 knots less. Up at 50 to go. Continue our flight over Spain at flight level 360, Mach 0.842, which will give us an indicator of 281 there. And we will start our descent about 100 or so miles from Malaga. Okay, I'm just going to go to the departure and arrivals page and pick up the Malaga arrivals. We're going to take a BLN. One Bravo arrival, which is going to give us a nice path in from the north, and we're going to be selecting ILS 31. This is going to be in the legs page, you can see here, and we're going to activate that. We're now going to get the magenta line. Runway 31 is the approach out over the water, so that will be a nice turn over the water. Now I'm going to hand over control now, not from my own flying, but to the LNAV control. However, to be able to do that, you need to be on intercept heading. So I'm going to turn to intercept, let's say 205 will do. And you can see the two waypoints there, BLN, Bravo Lima, November, and Vivas. I'll zoom in. Oh, wait, we can stay there for the time being, actually. Now, once I'm on an intercept heading, I can then press LNAV, and that will take over control and follow the magenta line. I'll do that a little bit nearer the line. If I zoom in, you can see that we're still quite away from the line. But we're now intercepting that imaginary line, which is going to take us in on a nice arrival star, what's called a star, standard arrival, into Malaga. We won't start descending yet. I'm going to give you a bit of a trick on when to know to start descending. Also bear in mind that there's a few mountains just before Malaga, it's hidden underneath some mountains, so we do need to maintain a bit more of a higher altitude before we go out over the sea for the final descent.